Hello everyone, this is Venugopal. Today in this session we are going to solve a solution for write a program to calculate sum of digits of a given input number. Before going directly for the program, let us understand the logic, right? Logic to add sum of digits entered by the user. For example, let's have a number. Suppose consider the user had entered like n is equals to, for example, 4, 5, 6. This is the number entered by the user. So now I want the result should be the sum of this digit should be, what is the sum? 6 + 4 = 10 + 5 = 15. I just want to print this result. It's a simple logic, right? If the user entered this number, I want to add each and every digit, like 6 + 5 + 4. Every digit I want to add individually, and ultimately I need to print the answer. So how to do that, right? To accomplish this task, we have some simple steps. Number one, get the number from the user. This is the first one. Second, very important step, find the remainder, or you can say get the remainder. Get the remainder using, you know, that we know that already, we have seen in some of my programs, remainder will be calculated, right, by using modulus operator, right? So second step is to find the remainder. Third thing, add remainder to some variable, right? And fourth step is now divide the number by 10. And here also, if I want to find the remainder, right, so we need to do the modulus with 10. Okay, and finally we will print the result. So how to do that exactly? Just we follow the steps, right, for this number. Now the number is 4, 5, 6. We got the number from the user. Now here I just want to divide this 4, 5, 6 with what? I need to find the remainder first. Remainder will be calculated if we are using what? Modulus operator, right? So 10 1045 is a 450. Yes. What is the remainder here? 6. This remainder will be stored in some particular variable. Let us say R. And then we will add this R to sum. So initially we'll take sum is equal to sum plus that number. So we'll declare initially this sum equal to 0. So 0 plus 6 is 6. So now the sum value is what? 6. What is the second step? We have added, right? First step we have done, then second step we have done, the third one also we have added the number. What is the fourth step? We need to divide the remaining number with 10 here. So n is equals to, sorry, so n is equals to n by 10. So what is n here right now? 45 divided by 10. Okay, now if I'll divide 45 by 10, 10 and this is 45. So 10 fourths are 40. So here we need to take this one quotient, and this will be stored in this particular n. So now n value will become what? 4. So we need to repeat these 4 steps, right, till my n is greater than 0, right? I hope you are getting. The first step is what? We need to take the number from the user. Second step is what? We need to mod this number with 10. So whatever the remainder we are getting, simply add this remainder to this sum variable. And after that, we divide this number, right, with a next number, right? For example, 45 is a number. If I'll divide this 45 by 10, then we'll get a 4 number. Here, just I've taken the example this 45. Otherwise, your number will be 456. Okay. So when you divide this, you will get the number like 45. After that, 4. After that, nothing. So we are one by one, we are completing the 6, 5 and 4. We have got 6. Then we have got 5 remainder. Then we got the 4th one. Then we are adding individual digits to form a digit sum of that digits. So let us take one example. We'll see this same thing practically. So I'll take a comment for this. Sum of numbers, input digits. So here, hash include stdio.h. Right main. And here I'm taking support n. I'll take only n. And here I'll take two more variables like comma r comma sum. And we know that whenever we want to add the digits, so better to initialize with the 0. Okay. Then we are asking a user to printf. Input number, right? Scanf %d, comma address of n. Then now we need to apply the loop here because we need to repeat that process whatever we have seen earlier. So while my n is greater than 0, I want to repeat this statements. What is the first step? After getting the number, we need to calculate the mod. So how to calculate the mod? So and that mod means what? That mod is going to be written a reminder. So I'm catching that reminder in R variable. So here n mod 10. This is the first time. What it will give? It will give a reminder. After that, sum equals to sum plus what reminder, right? We are going according to the stepwise, whatever we have seen in the description. Now, after that, what is the next step? We need to divide the number by 10. So n equals to n divided by 10. What it will give, right? This will give the quotient, right? Which reduces the number. Okay, so I'll write here. Quotient. Okay. And this process is going to be repeated till my n is greater than 0. Once the entire process is done and the condition will become false, it will come out of this loop and then will print the message, the required output. The sum of entered digits or input digits is colon %d comma, the answer is stored where? In the sum variable. So let us save this program and check for the output. Save it, compile and execute it. We'll enter the same number like 456. So we are expecting the answer is what? The sum is 15. Right, so this is what exactly to add the sum of digits entered by the user. For example, if we'll take another example like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, any number you can take now here. Suppose we'll take up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I'll enter, first you add this all numbers. 5 plus 4 is 9, 12, then 14, and again the result is 15. Right? So if we'll take the example of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and just try to run this program to understand this logic again. Right? These three simple steps are very important to find out this kind of thing. Whenever you want a last digit, for example, once again, I'll tell you by taking the example of on screen. So here, what number we have taken here? We have taken n is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now, if I want to take this last digit. Okay. So, what we are doing here? Simple. We are applying the formula like R equals to N mod. N means what? This number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then mod of 10. What it will give? It will give the remainder. Right? If we divide any number, if we mod any number with this 10, obviously the last digit will be come out. Okay? So then what we are doing? We are adding this remainder. Sum is equal to sum, which is initialized with the 0, plus remainder is what? 5. So the answer would be here what? 5. Because 5 plus 0 is? I'll do like this. 0 plus 5 is what? Is 5 only. So sum is what now? 5. Okay. What is the next step? Now we want the next number. This is earlier number. Now we want the next number. Right? How to do that? N is equals to, what is my current number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Divided by, if I'll do 10, then it is, what it will give? It always give the quotient. So what would be the quotient? Of course, 1, 2, 3, 4. So result will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? Now this 1, 2, 3, 4 is my new number. So this loop is going to repeat because we are checking whether this my n is greater than 0 or not. Of course, this condition is greater than 0. That is, again, it will go to this place. Now, this time, this number is not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This time, this number is what? Only 1, 2, 3, 4. So, remainder is what? Whenever you divide, whenever you mod off this number, you will get the last digit. What is the last digit? 4. Now, this 4 will be added here. Right? What is the sum? Sum is already 5. So, 5 plus 4 is what? That is equals to 9. Now again, we'll divide this number here. Okay. So this number is 1, 2, 3, 4. If we'll divide this, you will get the number what? 1, 2, 3. Again, this 1, 2, 3 is greater than 0. That means the loop is again to be going to executed here. Right? Now this time the number would be 1, 2, 3. What would be the remainder? Now you can guess. 3 is the remainder. Now it will be added to the sum variable. What is the sum? Already 9. 9 plus 3 is what? It's 12. Now this number 1, 2, 3 is the number, right? If you divide this by 10, you will get which number? 12. Now 12 is greater than 0. Again, the loop is going to be continue here. Now here, the number is what? 12. 12 mod of 10. Yes, the remainder is 2. So it will be add with the previous sum. What is the previous sum? 12 plus 2 is equals to 14. Now this number is 12, so here also we'll take 12. If you divide this 12 by 10, you will get what? You will get 1. Still 1 is greater than 0, so loop is again continue. And this time it divides 1, right? So result would be, yes, what's the result? 1. So now 1 will be added to the sum, right? So already it is 14 plus 1. The answer is equals to 15. Right? Again, this number is going to be divided by 10 now. Now, this time, this is not going to be divided by this one. So, it will return what? Question will be 0. Now, 0 is not greater than 0. So, it's not going to be repeat this 3 steps again. So, it comes out of from the loop and directly we are printing what is the result? The result would be 15. This is how the loop is going to be execute. Simply, I need to modify, like here I need to put what? While the number is greater than 0. Right? If it is so, then we are taking these steps. And finally, after loop is completion, we are printing the result. That is nothing but our program. That's all. So I hope you have got a clear idea about this program, how to calculate the sum of digits of any given input number, right? Two things you need to remember. Whenever you want a last digit, just go for remainder. Whenever you want to reduce the number, just divide by 10. That's all. You will get the result. Okay. So thanks for watching. Till then, bye bye.